Hello there everybody, Embix here and the studio is dark. That's because my studio light is painted towards my collectible minifigures. Yes, I've reviewed all the stands. Now it's time for the overview of all these figures. So figures, let's talk about what I consider a figure. I include mini dolls, I include R2-D2, I include BB-8, I include droids, and those are mainly the only questionable ones, you know? Then you got, I include big figs, but yeah. This is a total in my collection so far as of 2019. I think this is January, within the last 3 days, I think January 28th, I believe. This is my full figure collection and it has 588 minifigures. And I'm so excited right now because right after I do this video, I can do the studio tour, which I've been waiting to do. But I start with Star Wars to actually review everything and then rent this way. So let's start this way actually. We got like the kind of MCU Avengers stand right here with the main Avengers and then the more side heroes and then a bit of the Guardians of the Galaxy trying to collect the other ones. Moving on, we got the Black Order, not complete. I need one Outrider and to put Thanos on with his completed Infinity Gauntlet. It would look so cool, but I got the Black Order behind him. That's a work in progress stand that I need to make for the old MCU villains. Here is the Lego Ninjago movie kind of section. We got all the ninja right here, and then all of them in uniform and out of uniform, and then Sensei Wu watching over them. Here we have the kind of Garmadon army force, and then just the citizens of Ninjago City. We got a little castle stand and a Jurassic World stand. Those I hope to get more figures on. Here is the Ninjago stand, and then we got this kind of friends one. The mini dolls are just so easy to knock over. They're not durable at all, which is why a lot of them are knocked over. But here's the creator minifigure stand. And then we got the comics stand for DC and Marvel combined. A lot of people might not like me for doing that. But here we got the collectible minifigure stand right here with just a couple. And then we got my kind of custom minifigures where I paint the bodies over. And Thor also caught onto my mic cord. And I'm filming this right after doing my Stars collection overview, and that is why, you know, I said again or also because the Ewok did that. Watch that video to find out. But anyway, here's the Harry Potter stand. Quite recent because the Harry Potter sets are quite recent as well. Back there, we got the Lego Batman movie minifigures. The complete team of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles other than, like, what's his name? The rat guy? I forgot his name. But yeah, we got that. We got costumed minifigures. The city minifigures, I think those are like, 91 figures, I believe. And then we got the Scooby-Doo figs, the full mystery gang, and then two of their monsters. We got the DCEU stand, Superman, we got Aquaman, Batman, and then two Atlantean guards and a parademon. Here's the Simpsons minifigure stand right here. We have the Lord of the Ring and Hobbit sets of minifigures. So you got all of them. And then the Goblin King just looming over them, holding his scribe. And the tiny Chima stand, which I don't care about and I don't think anyone else will. We got this Jedi minifigure stand, the Resistance stand, all these bounty hunters, the First Order, some more Resistance figures, the Alien stand, the clones, the droids. Let's see, the U-Wing stand, the Ewok stand, the Rebellion stand now, not Resistance, some droids, and then we got the main heroes for the classic or original trilogy, the extended universe figures not appearing in canon as of yet, except the Mandalorian. I gotta change that now that he has been in Rebels. We got the Rogue One figures, a bunch for the Empire army, and then you got the Siths back there and the Imperial droids, and then these extra duplicate or different variants that I don't need figures. And then these one-of-a-kind figures were like, I only have one Minecraft figure, so I'm obviously not making a stand for it until that expands. But there's a quick look at those. And then he is just in the kind of a waiting room until I get Lego Movie 2 sets and make a stand for that. But yeah, that is it for this video. I think that I'm going to do, before my whole studio tour, I'm going to do one Lego discussion. But then it's going to be the studio tour. So yeah, that is it for this video. And I hope you liked it. And if you did, please subscribe, leave a comment down below. And I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.